I'm Scott Harrah, Director of Digital Content at UMHS, and as part of our UMHS Alumni Achiever series, we're speaking today with Canadian UMHS grad, Dr. Rebecca Bremner. Dr. Bremner is a family medicine physician who completed her family medicine residency at Louisiana State University in Bogalusa, Louisiana, after graduating from UMHS and also after completing her undergrad at the Ontario Institute of Technology. Dr. Bremner has now returned to her native Canada to practice family medicine, and we're here today to learn more about how UMHS helped her on her journey to becoming a doctor. And Dr. Bremner, good morning and welcome today.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Sure. Let's get right into it. Dr. Bremner, what about your medical education at UMHS helped you get where you are today?
So I would say the number of experiences that everything has come with studying abroad has really helped shape who I am as a person right now. So to be quite honest, prior to going to St. Kitts for med school, I had never flown before. The only reason I had ever really left Canada was to go on the odd shopping trip to like upstate New York. So it really helped me kind of grow as a person and to come out of my shell. Definitely put me in certain instances where I maybe didn't feel comfortable, but I think that ultimately that helped me grow as a person. And just the number of different places I've lived, the number of cultures that I've experienced has really helped me grow as a physician, because we deal with people of all walks of life. And so I'm able to just kind of like wrap all of that into when I'm having interactions with patients, how to handle different things.
Excellent. And speaking to both current and prospective students, what would you say are some of the best things about UMH being a UMHS graduate back practicing in Canada?
So the one thing, thinking back to basic sciences, and I would attribute to my success, is the quality of the professors that we had. So the way that our professors teach, I think, is different from if I had stayed here in Canada and gone to medical school. Some things are self-taught here. I don't think that that would have been a successful strategy for me. The fact that the professors just kind of lay out all of the information in a super easy to understand way. And if you don't understand that, that's okay, because they have tons of time where you're able to access them in like their office hours and things like that. So I think in basic sciences, that helped develop like the basic knowledge I needed to succeed. And then just the number of different clinical experiences that I had. So in medicine, like if you're kind of staying in one hospital setting and kind of dealing with the same attendings time and time over, you may not be able to kind of, the way I've chosen how to practice medicine, I've kind of picked and choosed from all the different doctors I've worked with, things that I liked that they did, or maybe things that I didn't like that I made sure I would never do again. And with all of the moving that I did, even though it at times was a little challenging to find housing and things like that, I'm really thankful for all the different physicians that I worked with in terms of my clinical rotations to help me just kind of figure out how do I want to practice medicine.
Okay, great. And is there anything about UMHS that you think is particularly appealing for Canadian students studying medicine abroad, besides the obvious things like the great weather in St. Kitts?
So I wasn't a beach person, which probably led to my success. I made sure I was always in class, but in terms of anyone applying to medical school in Canada knows, it's extremely challenging to get in. Even if you have perfect grades, you have good reference letters, it's not always enough. And I think I'm very thankful that UMHS kind of gives you that chance to not have to give up on your goals, and that they are so accepting of Canadian students. The difficult thing, of course, is always getting a residency to make sure that you're able to, you know, become board certified. And in choosing a Caribbean school, you need to make sure that you're going somewhere reputable, that has, you know, good rapport with different residency programs, so that you have that opportunity to match and to be able to be board certified. So I only applied to one Caribbean school, and it was UMHS, and thankfully I got in, and it led to, you know, where I'm at today. But I think the fact that UMHS is so reputable, that the Ross family has a really good background in terms of, you know, making sure that their students succeed, is how I ultimately chose this school.